It's Mazzy, and welcome back. Those of you who have been watching me know my channel is about the music, my record collection, and my times in San Francisco and the concerts I've gone to. And sometimes I talk about my own gear. I've done a room tour. It's time to do an updated room tour, a whole house tour, in fact, a music tour. Over the last several months, I've had several companies reach out to me, and frankly, I've been turning them down. And this video is about a specific starter, what I consider a starter turntable. And the reason I finally, after three requests, decided to have them send me this turntable is because I've been getting a lot of questions occasionally, a lot of comments about what's a good turntable to start out. Now, there's so many different ways to go, and I'm just one person. I'm not a gearhead that has been comparing turntables, but let's talk about this. This is the Angel Horn, and this is the H002BT turntable. These turntables are made in China. This is the Bluetooth model. I'll get into it. I don't do typical. Those of you who know me, I don't like to do unboxings, so I'm not gonna go through every little thing. But I'm gonna show you how easy or difficult it is to put it together. And what I wanna do is test it out in my downstairs second system and then with a separate Bluetooth, just a single speaker to see if it would be good. For instance, in my record room, I don't have a turntable. So I like to audition things and play some 45s and play records as I'm discogging. And I wanna see if it would be good for that. And I want to frankly see if it'd be good for a starter turntable or an early turntable. So I will hook it up down there. Here is the box, if you want to see the box. Beautiful box. In a way, I consider this, if you go to their website, this is like a lifestyle turntable. And of course, all the photographs represent that. But there are a lot of people who are new to vinyl and don't want to spend, you know, maybe even $500 on the RP1, the Riga turntable. So I do have an RP8, but that is, you know, a $3,000+ turntable plus a cartridge, and so you're going up to $4,000. I do have a Dual turntable from the 80s I bought, and I bought that in 1987 for $600, thinking that was gonna be my last turntable. And what I do like about that turntable, and this, what I've seen so far, it's got this walnut plinth, and I'm a big fan. If I don't go for the modern, like the Riga modern slick look, which I really like, I do like walnut. This, I think it has a walnut veneer plinth on this one, and we'll get into that in a little bit. So here we go with Angel's Horn turntable, and let's see. This is what the plinth looks like. It's got a very nice mid-century minimal look, which I like. I'm, again, a style freak, and I think the visualization is really important. You don't see that cheap plastic, although it is a wood veneer, walnut veneer. So probably MDF under here, I don't know, but it's got a nice simple look. And of course, the clear dust cover. So here we go with everything laid out. Here is the turntable unpacked and ready to be assembled. And it comes with the Audio-Technica cart. It's the AT3600. As I said, I think it's about a $25 retail cart that eventually you can upgrade. And it comes with your belt, which I will install, a 45 adapter. You can play singles. Now, this is a turntable that plays both 33 and 45. So I put the belt around the subplatter and around the motor pulley, and that's really easy to do. So it's almost like a no-brainer. That's the first step. You make sure there's a foam piece that goes under the subplatter to ship. You take that away, take all the foam out, clean it up, just use a soft cloth, I would imagine, to dust everything off. And then that's the first thing you do. Just make sure it is loose, and there you go. Okay, the next thing is to put the counterweight on, and you actually balance it. You will be balancing that a little bit, but you put the calibration numbers towards the front of the turntable. So you carefully, now keep this locked. And this is with any turntable, not just this. I am aware of that. It tells you to take off the cap. I'm going to wait on that to protect the stylus so I don't, you know, I'm prone to hitting things and I don't want to definitely hit it here. So I'm going to put this on and push it in forward a little bit for now. We'll leave like that. I'm going to unlock the tone arm. And you want it to float. See, this is really not right yet. So you're going to balance this out. You want it to slightly float. Now, one thing I'll notice, there's this little bag with a counterweight in it. And you'll notice it's almost like fishing line, almost like dental floss. Very delicate. You could almost miss that there is a filament on there. And this is your counterweight. And let it hang down. So I decided to first to hook it to a single Bluetooth speaker. The connection took a little while, the pairing of the Bluetooth, and I don't know if I can attribute that to the table or the separate speaker, but once it paired, it was fine. And actually, it sounds really clear, and I'm really surprised at how silent, how quiet this table is. No motor hum, no buzz, not at all. We'll see later when I hook it through a pairing, when I hook it actually through my stereo downstairs. I think this would be good for maybe a dorm room or even a small room. I'm thinking of using it down in my record room where there's no table while I'm discogging and auditioning records in 45. So I'm gonna check that out, but let's let this play a little bit. So I've been playing the Angel's Horn Bluetooth turntable for about a week now, and I've been playing it down in my office, in my other music room, next to, adjacent to my record library, through my stereo. I have a Denon amplifier, and through my Bauer & Wilkins, these smaller speakers, the 706 S2 speakers. And the turntable is replacing for the moment down here is a 1987 Dual CS5000 with a Grado cartridge. Now, I will admit that the Audio-Technica cartridge, even though it's only a $25 cartridge, is warmer in this room. I think also it's a newer cartridge and it'll probably break in a little bit. I don't know so much. My other cartridge literally I've had on that table for a good 10 years now. But I don't hear a huge difference between those two turntables. So I think what it comes down to is obviously your amplification, but your speaker source. The Angel's Horn definitely sounds better through the Bauer & Wilkins speakers. I would expect it to through stereo speakers rather than a single Bluetooth. These are actually plugged in to the Denon receiver and playing through it. And I've been blasting this thing, and the table itself, as I said, is totally quiet. So I think this would be a good intro turntable for someone, a good basic turntable for someone who's new to vinyl. Because of the price point. Now, they also have one I saw that you can get a combo with speakers. I haven't heard those speakers. I don't know what it sounds like. I suppose they're probably fine for small room applications. Obviously, this is a large room here, and I can, you know, my amp, obviously, this Denon's about, I think it's about 140 watts a channel. And through these speakers, it sounds really good. These are pretty efficient speakers. So anyway, check out this turntable. It may or may not be right for you, but I don't have any criticism of it. And for the price, it's really a bargain. I mean, $180 retail, you can get a discount. There is a link below with descriptions of the turntable, and there's a link with a code because they're letting me try this out. If it's something that does interest you, you can get a 15% off through their website. You need to make that decision. I'm enjoying it here, and it's not gonna compete with my RP8 with my Hagel amplifier upstairs, but it's not meant to, obviously, for the price. So thanks for watching. Enjoy the music. Check it out. Mazzy loves you.